und freuen uns auf den ersten Akteur. 29 Jahre ist er alt. Er kommt aus Köln und hat sich jetzt zum zweiten Mal für ein European Tour Event qualifizieren können. Das ist ein großer Abend und er hofft auf eure Unterstützung. Ein herzliches Willkommen, Florian Hempel! Gegner von Florian kommt aus dem Süden Englands, kommt aus Plymouth. Er hat ein tolles Turnier bei den UK Open gespielt, konnte Mark Webster, Raymond von Barneveld, Kim Heibrechts und auch einen Dave Chisnell bezwingen, verlor erst im Viertelfinale gegen Gerben Prison. Er ist aktuell die Nummer 65 der Welt. The Mirror Man, Steve Simonson. Florian Hempel. Gespielt wird die Distanz an diesem Abend über Best of 11 Legs. Man braucht 6 Legs, um in die zweite Runde einzuziehen. Und auch den Caller wollen wir herzlich begrüßen. Hubert!
Hello and welcome back to the Meimark Halle in Mannheim for the second session of action from the European Darts Match Play. It is another European Tour event. Our second in as many weeks. And it'll be 3-3 come a week Sunday, when the International Darts Open champion is crowned. A massive month on the European circuit as a number of players look to book their places at the European Championship, and some massive names that you're not often accustomed to seeing on the Friday action in the first round. Michael Smith, Max Hopp, Kim Heibrechts, Simon Whitlock, as well as Jamie Hughes, our winner in the Czech Republic on the European Tour, but hasn't launched himself up the rankings quite enough when the qualifiers for this were held, so I had to come through qualification, as everybody you will see tonight has. 16 players on the way, 8 spots available in the second round, and we start with Simon Stevenson. Not Steven Simonson, as he may have been introduced mistakenly. That's what his name is if you read it in a mirror. It is the Mirror Man. Although he's not the Shaving Mirror Man, is he? Because he's not been using one of those of
first
late.
First leg, Simon to throw first. Game on.
And it is Simon Stevenson against Florian Hempel, one of the Germans. I'm Dan Dawson, Paul Nicholson alongside me for the opening game of the night.
Got to say, there's a lot of dart players who trail the beard and the moustache around November time, which I'm all for.
45.
I'm about to put my hands together and clap Simon Stevenson, because I think it suits him.
Ah, I think it's a good look. Oh, listen to this.
Oh, Simon, this is what you're in for.
137.
Now, not only have we got a larger crowd, and it's a pretty decent crowd for a Friday night, this, but they've got one of their own to cheer for. They'll make an absolute racket for Max Hopp later. But Florian Hempel is a very 45. Interesting character. It's only the second time we've seen him on the European Tour after he tried to qualify for these loads. Loads and loads. Never got through. But he's only been playing the game for two and a half years. He's a former handball player. Absolute giant of a man. So our cameras had to zoom out a bit when they were focusing on throwing their practice darts, because you can't get Simon Stevens' head and Florian 85. Hempel's head in the same shot. But he made his debut at the Dutch Darts Masters, whitewashed Ryan Harrington with some really impressive stuff.
60.
And then took 3 legs off Simon Whitlock. So he's evidently got a bit of talent, and if he can back it up with a performance here, Simon Stevenson could find himself in trouble.
He could. Speaking of Florian very briefly, just after the afternoon session, and he looked as buoyant as ever. as buoyant as his fringe.
41.
Don't mess with him. He is very tall and very intimidating. But Simon's not the kind of guy who is intimidated by anybody on the door board, especially after what happened in March at Minehead, where he played exceptionally well.
Yes, became the last man
82
to play and indeed beat Raymond Van Barneveld at the UK Open, a tournament he had won before, of course.
Are you saying that Barney's not going to go in the Raleigh's qualifiers next year?
134.
Well,
Florian
Jouvequoyer,
60.
Tops for the big man. A little flick on the flight there. Resets for 10s. Listen to that. A very good start from Florian Hempel. Gets himself a wipe on the towel and a 1-0 lead.
Well, Simon Stevenson has not been 57. On the European circuit very much at all this year. In fact, he's only appeared once before. That was back in March, around that time when he was in some good form, played some good stuff at the UK Open, where he beat a badger and lost to a ferret.
60.
Dave Prince knocked out in round one. Johnny Clayton saw him off in round two.
I suppose that's what you get for beating a badger.
Well, that's it.
100.
The animals of Farthingwood will take their revenge.
I haven't really seen much of him in the last few months.
81.
And this part of the year, you've really got to kick forward if you're going to do something with your season. And in qualifying, he did something
121.
That nobody has done this year. He beat Steve Beaton in a qualifier. He was the man who broke the streak. 6-5 it was. He also beat Pete Hudson, 6-5. Just want to say massive condolences to the Hudson family, of
84.
Course. John Hudson, who is father of Pete Hudson, fabulous fella, who sadly passed away a few weeks ago. It was his funeral last week.
Yeah, I'd echo that. 45. Turns out that
Florian Jouvequoyer, 139.
Suffered a bereavement. He missed grandmother's funeral to be here today. He completed the afternoon session by beating Stefan Seidman.
99.
Again tomorrow. And at this rate, we'll be seeing Florian Hempel tomorrow because Simon Stevenson is barely in this match. He has only
85.
Had one
Florian
score
Jouvequoyer,
of a
40.
Ton or more in the entire game so far. And this is about to be two legs completed, is it?
30.
Not quite yet.
Simon, you require 170.
Outside chance. You wouldn't think it's going to go. And it isn't. Just doesn't seem to have the range on that first dart. He's been almost shell-shocked by the
60.
Reaction to Florian.
Florian,
he should really know
10.
What you're going to get with a home nation qualifier here in Germany.
Game
it's a 2-0 deficit. To Simon.
Simon, well, two for
the thing is,
game on.
Yeah, you know they're going to get support, but Simon may not have counted on there being as many fans in on the Friday. And also, he may never have seen Florian Hempel before.
45.
It's only that one appearance at the Dutch Darts Masters. Simon wasn't there, of course. And obviously, we like to think everybody sat at home watching PDTV for all these Euro Tours. It's the greatest tour of professional sport.
60.
But Simon does have a job to do. He fixes mirrors on luxury boats. Maybe out, or maybe he was just putting some intensive beard growing work in that weekend.
45.
There's Stefan Seidman there, who was defeated in the last game of the afternoon session. But yeah, you're right. A lot of guys out there will not
58.
Know a lot about Florian Hempel, and we didn't know a great deal about him until Svala, and now we know all we need to know. When he plays, we pay attention.
Yeah, I mean, he was just a name on a qualifying sheet, and he never made
98.
It through those qualifiers, Florian Hempel, until the Dutch Darts Masters. And look, he has got, it looks very uncomplicated, it looks quite quick, but
59.
His style, it doesn't seem much wrong with it.
It's quite deep into the collarbone when he brings the dart back. That's probably the only criticism I've got, but the thing is, he's quite handy with hand-eye coordination, isn't he? So I'm not going to second-guess him. I mean, look at the averages from qualifying yesterday. started with an 82. Then he went to 84. After that, he beat Michael Rosenau with a 94. That's much better. And a 93 to finish a 6-5 win over Kevin Munch, who played last week in Austria. So he played very well last night. Seems to me like Simon Stevenson is just about getting there with his scoring now.
It's better. That's his best visit. But, I mean, he's still thrown 15 darts, and he's back on 128.
45. Simon, you require 128.
Very poor scoring leg here. Didn't need to go treble 20, but didn't need to start on the 18s, to be honest.
I think that overcomplicates things if you go in the 18s in position.
56.
It's okay, but if Florian gets a 140, all the pressure will be mounted. Needs another. Gets
134. Simon, you require 72.
Double 12.
Game, he's in this game, Simon Stevenson. Simon Stevenson. Fourth leg, Florian to play first.
It's not been pretty. But he does get a leg.
Classy finish that, Dan. I like it when the pressure's mounted and you get those 60. Tricky two darters like 72. It's not the easiest finish in the world.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's it. He's done nothing all game, and then the back end of that leg, he's had a ton 40, a nice 72 darts, all of a sudden things start feeling a bit different.
There's one guy that you just cannot rattle, Simon Stevenson. He gives you nothing. And that makes him really hard to figure out as a player. I remember playing him in a qualifier, I think it was last season, and just couldn't get anywhere near him.
57.
It's his attitude that I really admire more than anything, because you can hit him with everything, he will take it on the chin, and he'll come back at you.
47.
Not one of those players who shows emotion about what you do or what he does. Reminds me of Mark Walsh.
135.
A little wristy flick, and he's finding the treble 20 more regularly. Stevenson has played at a number of the big tournaments in PDC darts, quarterfinals at the UK Open this 50. Year, of course, but he's also featured at the World Championship more than once. He's been to the Players' Championship finals a couple of times, including last year. He actually qualified for the World Series finals back in 2017.
85.
So he's got some experience, and he's played a fair few European tours, although not had any massively deep runs in them.
Yeah, he's waiting to really break 99. Through the final day
Simon
action.
It's
got to be the next ambition when it comes to Euro Tour. Howie would dearly love to do that this weekend. If he was to do the W over Florian Hempel, would get a game against Gezi Price, the number 3 seed this weekend.
78. Florian, you require 135.
Trouble 20.
I get the feeling he's lost 99. His range in that 60 in the last couple
Simon
of legs.
Requires six.
Simon gets his darts flat.
Gaze
oh, he could just hit it with
leg.
The first dart
Simon
like that.
Stevenson.
Really aggressive. Very, very
fifth
effective.
Leg, Simon to throw first. Game on.
I am perplexed though, Dan. Have a nickname like Mirror Man, and you don't come out to the song by the Human League. Here comes the Mirror Man.
Well, I mean, he did do it once.
140.
Quite sure I changed it, but. Now, there we go. There we go.
What's the German word for wallop?
Wallop.
Probably. They have some real aggression in dart 2 and 3 there. Really following up that first one.
85.
You ever been 44. To a handball match?
No, never. I've seen it on the telly when the Olympics rolls around. It does look quite good, actually.
Looks fun, doesn't it?
Yeah. I'm not sure I'd fancy Florian Hempel chucking anything at me from not very far at speed.
60. Boat.
The goalkeepers in that sport have it tough.
Yeah.
That is. I mean, there's. I'm not sure there's any diving for the ball. You're just trying to get off big and hope it hits you in the face.
100.
That was a bit like Lenny on The Simpsons when he's trying to scare a bear off. I'm big. I'm big.
Exactly like that. This is big.
140. Florian, you require 137.
Looking at the 57 first to take off the odd number.
25. Simon, and he feels 76.
Quite miserably, and it looks like it will be the lead for Simon Stevenson.
That's a dart at tops. Yeah.
36.
Doesn't quite pin it.
Slowing, you require 112.
Bend that wire with those heavy darts. This would be some sort of steal if he can somehow find that 60. What a shot! Double 16.
80.
For a mini second,
Simon,
I thought that was
40.
In. It wasn't. Confirmed by our referee, Hugh Ware. And Simon Stevenson can go for tops once more. He's pinned it again.
It was awkward, wasn't it?
30.
And that one wasn't very close.
Florian, you require 32.
Misses. Simon Stevenson could see him go behind again, and Hempel breaking the throw on double 16. That's what he does. And the crowd are being given something to cheer here. This is only his third appearance on the Euro Tour, third game on the Euro Tour, Florian Hempel. He's had a 6-0 win, a 6-3 defeat to a former European champion, and now he leads 3-2 against Simon Stevenson. It's fair to say that having spent quite a long while trying to get on the European Tour, now he's here, he's dangerous.
Yeah, I looked at this draw last night when it came out. And I thought to myself that Simon Stevenson was not going to have it all his own way. Because Florian Hempel, when he played in Zwolle, looked
99.
Comfortable. And it takes players a long time to feel that way on the European Tour stage.
Well, I mean, it's one of those, you're never quite sure how many transferable skills there are. I mean, Gerwyn Price, nobody really asks him anymore, but didn't really... There's no point. Every time somebody asks, well, playing rugby, does that really help you with this? And he didn't see that
100.
There was any skills. But there's got to be something to be said for getting up there and trying to perform in a sporting context with a big crowd watching.
80.
If you're used to that, and he will be from playing handball, then that's got to help getting up there, having the confidence to be able to go up there and just try and focus on your game and perform rather than worrying about what everybody's thinking or doing or cheering or saying.
100.
Yeah, there's other examples, of course. Think about John Bowles.
The Bulldog.
Yeah, fabulous dart player who played rugby league. It's obviously different because...
60.
You're not trying to clatter other people. It's not a contact sport. At least we are trying to keep it that way. But it's more mental than anything else. And if you've conquered the mental side in another sport,
60.
That is transferable for me. Nice. Too many times in this game he's been low on that 60, though. And he does throw down
46.
On it.
46. Simon, you require 142.
It's a bit sort of... He's coming up and he's having good visits. If he gets his first dart right, looks great. But then when he's trying to make adjustments, he doesn't seem to be doing it very successfully. If he sticks one in the 1 or the 5 or something like that, then he may be walking away with 41 or 26
90.
Or something. But if he gets that first dart right, then Florian Hempel is going big. And again, it's low.
Again, he stays there.
97.
He's a bit Max Hoplite when he is stubborn on that 60. Simon needs tops.
Keeps finding that bit, doesn't he?
Game on the sixth leg. Simon Stevenson.
Tops hitting was a particular feature of his run at the UK Open. His best run in any PDC major tournament.
Game on.
In fact, any stage tournament in the PDC, making the quarter.
Well, that song was a lot better last week when they were doing Roby John Rodriguez, Rusty, Jake Rodriguez. They were doing the whole family.
Well, I mean, there's enough of them. You can go for days at a time
40.
Just finding new RJ Rods to chant along.
That's a gorgeous first dart. You can see those darts lying really flat. And he's an exponent of maybe... the smallest flights in the professional game.
Yeah, little darts, 40. Little tiny arrows, aren't they, for Simon Stevenson? Not dissimilar to the setup, although not quite as long, that Mark McGeaney was using earlier this afternoon when he chucked 101 average and still lost to Bradley Brooks. But Simon Stevenson, he's getting them going with his first maximum.
That's
the first
a much
dart
better.
Is there.
140. Simon, you require 164.
These guys play the game very, very differently, but still very effectively. And Simon has been much more consistent on that 20 60. Segment after the first two legs, which were won by Florian. But he's now involved in a battle.
100. Simon, you require 104.
Single four. Three tops.
64.
See on his face, he's just not happy with his range on it. The previous visit he had in the last leg, he found a beautiful adjustment, but his 54. First shot on it every
Simon
time seems to
40.
Just be a little bit off. Can he find it this time? Yes, he can. It's central.
Simon Stevenson.
Right in the city centre of Plymouth, that one, which is exactly where he's from. Beautiful place. Is Plymouth in Cornwall or
57.
Somerset?
Devon, I think.
Devon?
Oh. Devon, I think. Who's
one of
I think if you cross the river, you're suddenly in Cornwall, but I might be wrong. Angry Devonians. Tony on Twitter, but
I'm going to get it.
This will be a slightly happier Plymouthian.
42.
Simon Stevenson.
Is that what it's called?
I think so, yeah.
Plymouthian.
Plymouthian.
I really like that.
One from Plymouth. Because he's had 2 180s in the last leg and a half. He's taken the lead for the first time.
95.
And he is dragging his average up into the 80s after a horrendous start to this match. His first appearance on the Euro Tour.
40.
For a long while, for best part of half a year.
You know what Simon Stevenson's fans are called?
Go on.
It's the Green Army,
97.
Isn't it?
The Green Army, of course, yeah. There we go.
I presume he's an Argyle fan. I mean, why wouldn't he be?
121. Simon, you require 129.
Are cheering when Florian Hempel gives them something to cheer about. But at the moment, Simon Stevenson is doing
97.
All the money. Oh. Okay. Well, is that a conscious decision to leave 32? Or has he just pulled it down from the 8 where he'd been leaving tops all game?
100. Simon, you require 32.
I think that may have been conscious. Just try a different target, keep things fresh. Misses on the outside, he's got plenty of room to sneak it in, just over the top.
No score. Florian, you require 141.
This is an outside chance, and based on what we've seen, it probably won't go, but you never know. I think the first start has been the big problem in this match
15.
For Florian Hempel. He's only averaging
Simon,
23 for that first start. It's the worst of the three for him.
16.
Well, 126 is so Florian much easier than 141. Forget about that last visit. This can go. Now it can definitely go. But only if you get the single.
94. Simon, you require 16.
A rookie mistake.
Florian Hempel may have just blown his chance because this is for a break and Simon Stevenson has missed 6 darts already. Make that 7.
Games
but he does not
leg.
Miss another, and the pump of the fist is the first time we've seen from Simon Stevenson in this game.
Leg, Simon two
but he feels
fist.
In control.
Game on.
Throwing for the match and a 6-3 win. He was 2-0 down in this, remember.
140.
Good position to be in. If you'd offered him 5-3. When he was 2-0 down, he probably wouldn't have believed that it was possible.
81.
Because Florian Hempel was the better player after a couple of legs, but just seems to me like the poorer first start of Florian since then has infected all of his games.
58.
Well, when we saw him play Ryan Harrington and win 6-0, he started off well and just did not look back. Everything he was trying was coming off. Here, he started off, took those two legs, and then when things started going wrong, he just seemed to get a little flustered. And even if you're experiencing a different sport, pressure can tell.
139.
Simon Stevenson is going about his business and has left himself on a checkout. It looks as if the Englishman is closing in on a 6-3 victory.
121. Simon, you require 164.
Good finish with a flourish. He's not going to. He's got time on his side, and that helps. Might have got time. You know what we were talking earlier about the follow-through of Brett Clayton? Said it was very Simon Stevenson-like.
Yeah.
They've got the same manager.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
140. Simon, you require 24.
Well, he was disappointed when Brett Clayton went out earlier on.
Game
but Simon Stevenson has turned this one
Simon
around.
Stevenson.
The mirror man. He was 2-0 down. He wins it 6-3. And Florian Hempel cannot give the German crowd what they want and kick this evening off with a host nation victory. Simon Stevenson, he's beaten a handball player. He'll now take on a former rugby player. Gerwin Price, the number 3 seed, awaits. Game 2 of the night, though, we'll see Jamie
Simon
Hughes back
Stevenson
in action. The Czech Darts Open winner takes on Wesley Plezier of the Netherlands.
Price zu tun, der hier an 3 gesetzt ist. Und das Aus für Florian Hempel. Trotzdem noch mal einen großen Applaus für Florian. So, mal hören, was Simon sagt. Congratulations, Simon. I would say it was not the A game, but it was a start in the tournament, right?
It was very slow, yes. Trying to get into it, trying to relax, and it took a while, but I started to get there in the end.
Gerwin Price, the next one. Totally different match, I would say.
I need to start as quick as possible to try and get on him. But yeah, good friend of mine and fantastic player.
Is the start in a match best of 11 legs the important thing against one of the top 10 guys?
Yeah, of course it is. You need to grab as what you can when you can. And certainly in the beginning, you want to try and get up the upper hand. Yeah.
But you know how to do it, right? UK Open, there was a big tournament.
Yeah, of course. It was a great run. I felt I should have done more against Gerwin, and I'll try and do that tomorrow.
Okay, see you tomorrow. Thank you very much. Simon Stevenson. Er sagt, das war ja ein langsamer Start. So.